That is Blackie. This is the king of the Topi Plains pride. And back behind there, the whole pride is coming. Led by this mighty, most powerful males. This is Lipstick over here. And Blackie is back there looking at the rest of the pride as they come straight across the plains, back to this hill.
We've got Notch with her two tiny cubs. She's actually moving them right out in the open. It's a dangerous move, but the rest of the pride are up ahead. Jackson's there with Blackie and Lipstick. And I'm just hoping that she doesn't bump into hyenas. They are tiny. You can see the way Notch, she stops every so often. She looks around, she's thinking about, you know, is there danger ahead? She's an experienced mother. She's done this kind of thing before. This is a huge moment in these little cubs' life. I mean, they're sort of ankle high. They look way too small to be brought into the open. But this is actually the break-even point. This is the time when lionesses tend to bring cubs to join the rest of the pride. And look at this expanse of plain behind me. I mean, she's probably walked a kilometer with those cubs, and they are tiny. But she did it. And the rest of the pride are just around the corner. She scaled the mountain. She's got those two little cubs to safety right where she wanted them. What a morning.
Blackie and Lipstick have led their pride straight into this rocky outcrop. Cannot have a better place, peaceful place for all of them. This is good. Why is he running? He's running after something. He's going after something, I don't know what. Gosh, what is he after? We don't know what he saw. Is it another male? Is he another female? I don't know, but he's running. Don't know how I'll get out of here, but look how difficult it is to follow him. And because this male have got up and run, the chances of the rest of the members coming to join is high. This is the excitement of the Maasai Mara. When cats are in action, we've got to act just like them. Well, I see quite a few hyenas up there. Look at them, look at him running. Look at him coming. Wow, all the hyenas are running. They see the king coming. Everybody is just exploding and running away from him. Wow. Look at him come. He might be limping, but he rules. Now I can see why he was running towards this direction. There's a kill. These are his older sons, Lipstick and Blackie, sired these four sub-adults. The subs came to steal that impala from the hyenas. Unbelievable. And look, Lipstick, they don't even care. All what they want is to make sure that this territory is well claimed, is well protected.
You can see how much bigger Lipstick is than these other young males. I've just noticed one of these young males is wearing a satellite collar, and that is helping the Mara Lion Project to track the movement of these young males, because we want to know what happens to these young males when they disperse from their pride, because we seem to be losing quite a lot of them, probably because they are at the forefront of conflict situations, taking cattle from the Maasai pastoralists. This is a pivotal time in the life of these young males because soon they will be forced out of the pride. But by the look of this one, it's not just about food. I think he's interested in that young female. And that could be a mistake. What can I possibly add to that? In terms of power, in terms of demonstrating who's boss? I mean, you saw the way Lipstick just stood tall and defied those young males. And then, very significantly, Lipstick marked his territory. He scuffed his feet, he peed, and he did it right next to the two females, because this is what this is about. It's all about access to females, not about food. There's nothing left of that carcass. I got a feeling that is the end of one heck of a morning. I mean, goodness me. Those youngsters, I mean, they think they're ready, but not yet. In fact, not for quite a time. And Lipstick was just saying to them, you know what? You just wait in turn. I'm not ready to step aside yet. This is my place.